Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Sylvia from Sylvia Craft. Today I'm going to be showing us how to make this elegant beaded ball. I'm going to be using four different beads, different colors of beads and sizes. And I'm using two beading needles. When I finish the first step, I'm going to start using one needle. But for easy access and easy feeling, that's why I'm using my needle. You can also decide using one your fishing line alone. If you have wire for this work or a tiger tee, you can as well use this. And so I have my cutter to cut out the excess, and I'm using my fishing line is 0.30. That's what I'm working with. Then I have my two beading needle size 9. So here I have my size 2 seed bead good, size 2 metallic good, and I have size 1 black, and I have my 4mm bicon good. So to start with this design, I'm going to pick three good. 3 bicon bead, then I drop it. I will let it drop. Then I will take one to crisscross it. Crisscrossing, I mean you take one and opposite direction you pass your needle through. Then I will let it drop at the middle of my fishing line. I'll let it drop to the middle. Then when I do that, the first step, I have this. So the next thing to do, I'll pick one on my right, one on my left. I'll let the bead drop. Then I'll take one to crisscross it. I'll crisscross. Then I'll pull it. Here I have the second one attached. So the next thing, one on my right, one on my right, one on my left. I'll let it drop. Then I'll take one again to do the crisscrossing. Then I'll pull it. Now I have the third one attached. The next thing I will do again, I'll pick one on my right, one on my left. I'll let it drop. Then I will crisscross with one. And I will put it, I'll crisscross with this one here. Then I will pull it. I'll pick again one on my right, one on my left. I'll let the bead drop. Then I will take one again to crisscross. So here, when you keep crisscrossing, I have this here. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this, I'll make it until I get the 9th one. This side, when you count it from the side like this, you should have 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'll make it when I get to the 9th one, and I will show you the next step of this design. At this point, I've gotten to the length I want it. So if you count here, you see we have, by the side you count, you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So the 9th one is what I added. So at this point, I'm going to then pick one more time, one bicon on my right, one on my left. And I'll let the bead drop. Then I will turn this bead this way. I'll pass my needle. I'll use this first one I started with to crisscross my bead needle in this direction like this. Then I'll crisscross the boat needle now. After crisscrossing it, then I will pull tight. When I pull, I'll use it to make to become a circle. So this is what I have now. You see it like this. When you put your finger through, you see it. This is what I have. It's a circle now. So at this point, you hold one side. I'm holding this side, then I'll take my right needle. The next thing to do, I'll pass my needle through this first bicone here, the first one, then I'll pull it. Now I'm going to be adding the 110 seed bead metallic, one of it, then I will take one and pass through the next 4 mm like this. I have this one attached. Then I will pick another one and pass my needle through the next one. This will help reinforce this 4 mm. I'll pick another one and pass it through the next bicone. Remember this process, don't forget it. And I'll pick this and I'll do it again. I'll do this on both sides. On both sides, doing the same thing. When I finish this part, I'll do same on the other part. This is what I'm doing. Pick one, pass my needle through the next one in front. Then I will turn it, pick one, pass my needle in front. Then I'll pick one again. I'll pass my needle to the next one like this. I'll pick one again. I'll pass my needle to the next one. Be careful so that it will not tangle like this. Then I'll pick another one. I'll do the same thing. Now this is where I started from. So remember to hold tight so that it will not loose. Then I will, here, I'm going to do the last one. I'll pick this and pass it through this next one here, the next 4 mm. This is where we started from. So here, this side is done. So I'm going to do the same thing with the other side by turning it. So at this point, this is what I have. I'm done doing it on both sides. This is it. So the next thing now, coming out from this bicone, I'm going to pass my needle through this 110 here. Then after doing that, I'll pick 3 metallic gold, 3. Then I'll pass back through this place, this 110 seed bead where I came out from, like this. Then I'll pull it. When I pull, I have this. Then the next thing, I'll pass my needle through the bicone and through the 110. Then I'll pull it. I'll pull. Then I'll pick 3 again. After picking those 3, I'm going to go back from this metallic. Then I'll pull. Now I have it attached this way. The next one, I'm going to pass through the bicone and the saver. I'm going to pass through the bicone and the metallic. Then I'll pick 3 again. I'll pick three and I'll pass back through this. And now I have this. I'll do this one more time by passing my needle through these two here. Then I will pull it and I will pick three of this, three of the metallic 11-0. Then I'll pass back through it again. Then I will pull. When I pull, I have this. So I'll continue in this order till I cover this part. Then I go back, I'll do the same thing to this other side. So when I finish this same thing on the both sides, then I'll show us the next step. Remember, this is what we're doing now. At this point, this is where I am, the last one. So I'm going to pick the last three metallic. Three, then I go back through this one here. Then I pull. So I have the both sides, I have this completed. So the next step now, so after passing through this, the next thing to do, I'm going to step up with my fishing, my needle, by passing through these two beads here, coming up this way. So I have it like this. Now I have my fishing line coming out of this top part from the last bead we picked. So now I have it like this. This is where my fishing line is coming out from. So the next thing I'm going to be picking now is the 3mm seed bead. This 3mm black, I'm going to be picking it. Then I'll pass through the next one here. This top beads here, like this. So I have this first one attached. Then I'll do this same thing for the both side by picking one 3mm black and passing it through the next one. Remember this step, don't forget it. So this is what I have now. I'm going to continue till I'm done filling the both side of this. Just like this. Then I'll pick another one, pass it through this one, like this. Hope you can see what I'm doing. Like this, I'll pass it through this next one. I'll pick another one. To the next. To the next. So I'll do this thing on both sides. When I'm done doing it, when I'm done doing the same thing on both sides, then I'll show you the next step here. So this is the last one. Then I'll pass my needle. So this is what I have. I'm done with this part. Then I'm going to turn it and I'll start the same thing with this other part by passing my needle. This is where I ended. Then I'm passing my needle through these two seed beads in front like this. Then I'll start picking the black one, the 3mm, to the next one. So do this. When I get to that point, when I get to the last part, then I'll show you the next step. So this is the last one. What I did to others, I'll just do the last part here by picking one 3mm and I'll pass it through this next one. So at this point, this is the end. Remember, we've done the both side. This is what we have. So the next step now, at this point, the next thing to do, after I finish with the black ones, I'm going to pass my needle through this black here, this first one here, then I'll pull it. Then the next thing, I'm going to be working with gold 11-0. Then I'll pick three of it. Then I'll pass back through this black where my fishing line is coming out from. Then I'll pull it. So I have this first one attached. The next thing, I'm going to pass through this metallic and through this black here. And I'm going to pull my needle. The next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to pick three again. Three good. Like this. And I'm going to pass back through this bead. That's the second one. So the, after I've finished adding these black ones, the 3 mm, the next thing to do, I'm going to pass my needle through one of the blacks like this. Then this time I'll be picking three good 11-0. This is what I have. Then coming out of this black, I'm going to pass through the back. Then I will pull. So I have this added. Then I'm going to pass through this again, through this metallic and the black one here. And this black one. And this black one, I will pull it. Like this, I will pull. Then the next thing, I'm going to pick three again, to it, three seed bead good. Then after picking the three, like this, then I'm going to pass through this back, the back of it, and through the metallic and the next, black in this direction. Then I will pull. Now I have the second one attached. Then I'm going to pick another three again. Three good. Three good. Then I'll pass back through this black one and the metallic and the next black I'm going to work with. Now, like this. The next thing, I'm going to pick the good again. I'm going to pick three of it. I'll pass through the back of this black and through the metallic and the next black in front like this. Then I will pull. I'll do this one more time by picking three good. Picking three good. Then I'm going to go through the back of this 3 mm and through the metallic and the next black in front. Like this. Then I will pull. I'll continue like this. I'll continue in this pattern until I've gone round. I'll do this for the both side. Then I'll come back to show us the next thing. At this point, this is what I have now. I'm done attaching the good to this side and also to this end. So the next thing I'm going to do, this is the last one I have here. And I'll pick three just to complete the same pattern. Then I'm passing through the back of this black. This will be the last one on this row. Then I will pull it. When I pull it, I have this. So the next thing I'm doing now, I'm going to then pass my needle through the next one in front, this two seed bead here. Then I will pull it. When I pull, now I'm coming out from the middle one. So I'm going to go around the middle ones of this other one like here. This I'll go through the second one here. The one at the middle. I'll pass through this. As I'm doing this, I'm pulling it. The next one, the middle. Remember the three we picked? I'm going through the middle one. That's the second one. I'll pull it. I'll go to the next one, the middle. I'll do this for all of them. Then I'll come here, the middle one, remember, I'll pull. I'm going only through the middle ones. I'll pull this. Through the middle. I'm pulling it, the middle ones. Don't forget this step. We are done with this design after pulling this together. Then I'm pulling it. Then the next one, I go through the middle of this. Then I'll pull it. Then the next one, I go back to the middle of this. This is where I started from. Then when I pull together, I will have this. I have to pull it together very well. So this is what I have after pulling it together like this. Then once I have this, the next thing I'm doing now, I'm going to take this needle. I'm passing it through this gold bead down here. Then through this black one and through this metallic, then I'll pull. Remember, I'm now at this point, I'm taking it to where I'll tie it before cutting out the fishing line. I'm going back to the 4mm bicone we started with. So here I have this fishing line at the middle here. This is where my fishing line is coming out from, at the middle. So this same thing I did here, I'll do it to the other part. Then the boat needle will meet here. The boat needle will meet at this point where I'll tie it. So when I do the other part, then I will show us the result. At this point, my boat needles are facing the same place. They are facing the opposite side. So at this point is to tie it. I'm going to tie this 3 times. Then after cutting it, after tying it 3 times, I will cut out the excess here. This is what I have. And I'm going to tie this. So here is the end result. If you find this video interesting, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Share my videos, like them. Comment if you have any question. And if you've not subscribed to my channel, don't forget to do so for more interesting video. See you next time. Bye-bye.